still got Mackey. All right. You're doing a picture?
Well, I need a duck then. That's a D1. All right, let's kick on. Madam Clerk, are we ready? All right, everybody, we're going to convene our Finance Committee meeting. Madam Clerk, 723-3, please.
Resolution 723-3, a resolution to authorize the county mayor to enter into and execute an agreement with GeoSynTech Consultants for data gathering through analysts and selection of preferred alternative for the McDonald Farm Dam in an amount not to exceed $101,483.48.
Thank you, ma'am. Ms. Cooper, anything to add?
This is the source's bond fund on this. We're just going to have to do some investigation. We've had the dam out there at McDonald Farms been failing, and we're required by TDEC to do some repairs to that. So that's what we're taking care of.
This covers the repairs or the analysis?
This is the analysis, and the recommendation by the consultants as to what their best recommendation is to how to fix what our problems are.
Okay, got it. Thank you. Commissioner Sharp?
Yes, thank you, Chairman. I was just curious. This is something I've not considered. I'm just curious as to what the maintenance costs for a dam like this could be on the long term. Is this something we can anticipate having to keep up with regularly? And what purposes do we have foreseen for the property?
Right. The maintenance costs of the dam really long term are not a cost that would be something that would be an ongoing cost. The dam, the pond was built by the family. There's a natural creek that runs through that piece of the property, and the McDonald family built the dam to kind of create a pond there on the property. They've stocked it with fish. Over a period of time, the dam has created, there's some, and Mr. Lehman can speak better to this, but the area around it has formed kind of a sinkhole, and it's begun to erode. So TDEC has recommended that because this falls into their safe dam program, that we have to do some repairs to the dam, or we have to completely breach the dam or take it out of the safe dam program. So there are some options that we have to work with. So this is the team that's going to tell us what our best options are going to be. Repairs to the dam, we have an estimate so far that might be, a hefty cost, but we're looking into some funds that we might be able to get from other sources that would be outside of some things, costs to us that we would have. So we're kind of trying to gather all the information right now before we commit to anything.
Well, I think it's always smart to do. What you said, hefty cost. What's a hefty cost?
I think initial estimates were around the $1 million.
That's hefty.
That's hefty. So that's why we're doing the investigation now.
What's the cost involved with, what was the terminology you used? Total breach or I don't know the terminology. I forget. I'm sorry.
So the pond is located completely on our property, right. And we have the option to either we have the ability to remove the pond and the dam from the safe dam program, or completely breach the dam and just allow the creek to return to its natural creek flow. So this the GeoSyntec consultants are going to do some surveying, some geotechnical subsurface data gathering, provide us with a report, observations, photos, lab test results, things of that nature, and then make a recommendation to us as to which of those options might be better. If they come back and tell us that, you know, it would be best to just completely breach it and allow the creek to go back to its natural state, we can take that option. If we can find some, maybe some grant funds that allow us to repair the dam back fully to allow us to keep the pond as it was built to be a pond, and a recreational site that we could preserve for the McDonald Farm Park, then that might be an option for us. And we're exploring that as we go.
Okay, but we don't have costs. We don't have any idea what the varying costs would be.
Not yet.
So we got to spend $100,000 to figure out what we need to spend.
That's correct.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Chairman.
Yeah, I'm sitting here thinking $101,000 taxpayer money for someone to tell us what to do is a lot of money, especially if we've got an idea it's going to be $1 million. So if someone's going to charge us 10% of the cost to do something to tell us what to do, I don't know. Is there, Ms. Cooper, I'm not a damn expert. that didn't come out right. I think you know what I mean, $101,000 for someone to tell us what to do. That's what's mind boggling to me. And they're not doing anything. They're just looking and they're giving us recommendations. I'm sure they're doing samples and so forth, but $101,000 to tell us what our next steps are.
So, and I think maybe Mr. Lehman could explain a little bit of why we sort of have to do some of these things. There are some regulations that TDEC has. We do fall under the Safe Dam program. There would be some fines if we were to do nothing. He's got more of an understanding of what those things might be. So we did have to go in. The Highway Department did go in, and I believe, and Mr. Lehman can speak more to this, lowered the water level already to kind of help with some of the issues that we had there. But it is a lot of money. It's a lot of money to determine whether we want to preserve the pond. A lot of work and money has gone into creating that pond. And then if that is something that we want to preserve for the park itself, it might be worth that money to preserve that valuable asset for that park.
Is there more than one person that can come out and give us another quote? That's to me is mind boggling. Somebody that much money, and I know it's beyond your control. And so please,
right.
You know, So Mr. Chairman, that's mind boggling to me that amount for someone to come tell us what our problem is.
Understood. Commissioner Mackey.
Thank you, Chair. Christy, we bought this property a couple of years ago, and I think we were to put 10, 11 industrial pads on the site. Are we already marketing any of this property or what?
I'm sorry, Commissioner, I can't speak to that. I don't know the answer to that.
Mr. Lehman is right behind you.
Well, the chamber's engaged with us, and we're currently doing a little bit of a site selection to get it certified with Tennessee ECD. So, yes, sir, there are. My office isn't, but we've been engaged, obviously, with the mayor's office and the chamber. And so we are talking with individuals, or they're talking with individuals about the site.
Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, sir. Commissioner Sharp, another question?
Yeah, Chairman, thank you. I just heard a term used a few times, and it's unfamiliar with me, and I'm curious if there's something more I need to understand about a park. I was under the impression that we bought this property to be developed for job growth in Hamilton County, and the whole idea, the park idea is new to me. So I just, I think that maybe there should be some time spent to help explain that. We don't have to do that today. It's,
no, but, sure. Absolutely. There's, you know, out of the over 2000 acres there, there are a lot of spaces there that are going to be developed for industrial uses. There are also additional spaces there that are not usable for development in that way. And we intend to preserve those spaces for use by the community as a park. For instance, we intend to preserve the the homestead space and the space surrounding the homestead to be used as a recreation space, as a passive use park for the community. One of the things that we learned when we went and spoke to the Sail Creek community was it was very important to them to preserve the history, the historic nature of that particular piece of land. And I think that we would be remiss if we went in and you know, kind of bulldozed all of the beautiful things that exist right there in that homestead area. So our intention is to, and based upon surveys that we had previously done, there are parts of that property that are simply unusable from an industrial manner. So what we cannot use for development will be intended to use by the community and other ways, as a park is one of those.
Yeah, so the homestead part, I remember the homestead part.
Yeah, and the, sure, the pond is very close to it. I mean, the creek and the pond that runs through that area would not be usable as industrial space.
This is the pond that's like up on the, kind of right up on the, almost up on the ridge, right? So I'd have to look at it again. Chairman, I don't need to belabor this anymore. I probably need to sidebar. Thank you so much for the time. Thank you, Christy.
Commissioner Mackey, you have another question, sir? Good. Okay. Ms. Cooper, there's obviously some questions around this that aren't necessarily specific to this one item, but definitely concerns related to this item. So I heard a number of them being the price point. I don't know if this is something that we can revisit before next week and just see, is this truly realistic? Are there others that may be able to take a look at this for us? The other part is somebody might want to speak to the plans moving forward. I totally get with green space, even residential neighborhoods, we ask them to maintain some level of green space for the community. So that would make sense. But if this is the first people are hearing about it, it might be interesting to know. And it makes sense. We probably couldn't use this property as industrial space. Mm-hmm. But making that clear, because even spending this amount of money to then make it industrial space later isn't something I think any of us would want to do. So if somebody could speak to that, and maybe this is for next week, just for a point of clarification, that might be helpful so that everybody understands the importance. I understand TDEC requiring us to do something. Mm-hmm. I don't know that this 100,000 plus a million is the answer, but maybe it is. I don't know. But if there's any way to clarify that, that would be really helpful for next week.
Before you leave that, Todd, in terms of sewage, the ability to take the waste away, what's going to happen there?
We've created three preliminary engineering reports relative to water, sewer, and access off of 27. So there's a plan in place that was an engineering report to get sewer to that site in a couple of different phases. And then what we do with that PR at this point is we're looking at some other funding opportunities, potentially grants, other ECD money. So we have a plan that's been developed for both sewer, water, and access, and we've developed reports that lay that out.
In your opinion, Todd, is it a Band-Aid? Do we really need a sewer? Is Ray County going to put a sewer in and take those potential home buyers into their county, or what?
Yeah, the current plan is to put a regional pump station there at the site to serve the park and the area, whether it be residential, commercial, along that 27 corridor, and then pump it north into the city of Dayton. And we've had those conversations, and the engineering report reflects that.
Are you implying that the potential homes going in will not be in Hamilton County, or will be in Ray, or what?
Well, there's a portion to, I guess, to Commissioner Smith's point, there's a portion of that area, at least from a grade perspective, be very difficult to do industrial. So there will be home air there. This regional pump station has been sized for homes in that drainage area, drainage basin, which would include Hamilton County and our property related to the McDonald's site. And it may even include some other houses in Ray County that probably would flow by gravity to this regional pump station.
You know, as you well know, we bought that with the intent of developing it, and it wasn't the intent to put those jobs in that neck of the woods so that people can live in Ray as opposed to Hamilton. So to that point, will we need a pump station in Hamilton County?
Yes, sir. We need a pump station.
Are we anywhere near getting one?
Well, we've developed the engineering report and the plans. No, sir. We're working through a process to now look at funding to provide sewer to that site.
Okay. Will we need a wastewater treatment plant there?
The preliminary engineering report does not speak to a wastewater treatment plant.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Commissioner. Before we move on, we'll make note that my friend Mark Harrison's got to be the only person I have ever seen smile big when somebody says sewers. It was just a great reaction when I looked up and I saw, and everybody's kind of, then Mark's smiling. Anyways, okay. Thank you, sir. Madam Clerk, let's move on. 723-4, please.
Resolution 723-4, a resolution to relinquish Hamilton County's interest in a 1993 Freightliner Model F80 fire truck co-titled with Sell Creek Volunteer Fire Department.
Thank you, ma'am. Hey, Chief, the first part of this says relinquish. The second part says surplus. Is there a difference?
We relinquish the title and then they surplus it. So it's kind of we're turning over the title so they can surplus it.
And the funds would go where?
From to them, where they buy rescue equipment or whatever they're needing.
Okay, so we are relinquishing every aspect of this, and then they can do with it as yes, sir. Place. Okay, just to be clear. All right, no other questions? Madam Clerk, 723-5, please.
Resolution 723-5, a resolution to relinquish Hamilton County's interest in a 1978 Pierce Model 138 fire truck co-titled with Sell Creek Fire Department.
Same deal, Chief. Madam Clerk, 723-6, please.
Resolution 723-6, a resolution establishing the minimum bid amount for certain parcels of property acquired by Hamilton County through previous delinquent tax sales, authorizing the offer of said parcels for sale at the minimum bid amount, and authorizing said parcels to be offered for sale for an amount less than the total amount of taxes, penalty, costs, and interest accumulated against the property.
Thank you, ma'am. Mr. Lehman, the last time we saw this item not too long ago, we had 21 properties. Do you know what the count is on this one?
Commissioner, I'm going to let Lynn Mansfield, sure. She's our manager of real property office. They handle, I'm going to let her answer on these next three because her office processed all those.
Great.
Good Ms. morning. Mansfield. We have 24 parcels that we are offering in this sale. And that should be also included in the packet. That was a supporting 24. Document.
Yeah, I just wanted it read, Ms. Mansfield, that's all.
Yes, okay.
You know, it wasn't a check. And thank you so much for the direct and just straight answer. I can't tell you how much I appreciate that at times. Madam Clerk, I see no further lights. 723-7, please.
Resolution 723-7, a resolution authorizing the county mayor to execute all documents necessary to convey to the city of East Ridge, Hamilton County's interest in certain properties jointly owned by Hamilton County and the city of East Ridge.
Thank you, ma'am. Similar question as far as number, but then I've got the why.
Okay, so prior to placing any property in a sale, we notify the city of Chattanooga and any municipality to see if they may have an interest in the properties that are jointly owned with the county. In this case, East Ridge has requested two properties. There is some FEMA money tied to these properties. They have demolished some structures that were in a floodplain. And according to the FEMA guidelines, these properties must be maintained as vacant lots. So we would have really no interest in selling those anyway because they cannot be developed.
Okay, so would these be, these are not included in the previous
Correct.
Count? Okay, so these are separate. Addition.
Correct.
And there are two lots that we basically will, we will sell or we will just
convey,
transfer?
We will convey our interest to the city of East Ridge and they will own them outright.
And they must be maintained as empty lots once they're cleared?
Correct, because they've used, FEMA has given them a grant and they've had those structures on both of those lots demolished.
Interesting. Okay. Thank you. No other lights. Madam Clerk, 723-8, please.
Resolution 723-8, a resolution authorizing the county mayor to execute all documents necessary to convey to the city of Saudi Daisy Hamilton County's interest in certain property jointly owned by Hamilton County and the city of Saudi Daisy.
Thank you, ma'am. Ms. Mansfield, same thing.
Same thing applies, correct.
Thank you.
Just the one property in Saudi Daisy.
Just one, good. All right, I see no lights on that. That is the last item we have for finance. Anything further from this committee? Seeing no lights, we're adjourned. Thank you, everybody.